time, we're going to solve another problem on section properties using Mohr's circle. Okay, so we're given a certain area with the following properties, such as the IX is 40 million mm to the fourth, its IY is 100 million mm to the fourth, and its IXY is equal to 40 times 10 to the 6 mm to the fourth. Okay, so now, yung IXY is actually the same with the PXY. Product moment of inertia. Okay, so there are some books kasi using IXY to be the symbol for the product moment of inertia. Then, out of these given properties, we're asked to determine for the maximum and the minimum moment of inertia, I max tsaka I min. Then, also, we're asked to determine for the angle that the axis of maximum moment of inertia makes with the x-axis. Okay, so let us solve this one. Okay, so at first, let us analyze the given properties. So it has its IX 40, its IY 100, and its product moment of inertia is 40. So obviously, it is not zero. So what does it mean when we have a section with non-zero product? So based from my previous video, whenever we have a non-zero product moment of inertia, that means that the section is not symmetrical about X nor about Y. So that means the section is unsymmetric about X and Y. Now, so let us assume, so for our basis lang. Okay, so let us assume a section which is not symmetric about X and about Y. So for still section, maybe we could assume it as an angular section. Okay, so assume angular section. Okay, so angular section. Now, for angular section, which do you think would be longer? The horizontal leg or the vertical leg? Okay, so take a look of the IX and the IY. Okay, yung IX is the resistance about the X-axis, 40 million. Yung IY is the resistance about Y-axis, 100. So, ibig sabihin, mas mataas yung resistance niya about the Y-axis. So, sinong mas mahabang leg kung mas malakas yung resistance niya about Y? Edi, dapat yung horizontal axis or yung horizontal leg would be the one having the longer leg. Something like that. Okay? So, assumption lang naman yan. So, para lang meron tayong basis. So, let's say this is the centroid of the angle. So, this would be the centroidal x-axis. And this would be its centroidal y-axis. Okay? So, assumption lang yan. Now, next. So, again, using Mohr's circle, what we need are the two. Okay, so using Mohr's circle, so we need the two points. Again, the IX, comma, the PXY. Number two is we have the IY, comma, the negative of the PXY. So hindi pwede magkapalit sila ng partner, ha? So yung first point coordinate, parati ang magka-partner is yung IX tsaka yung positive PXY. Tapos yung second point coordinate, laging magka-partner, yung X and Y coordinates are the IY tsaka yung negative of the PXY. Hindi pwede magkapalit. Okay. So for this problem, so we have our IX is 40. So parehas, lahat naman sila times 10 to the 6. Tanggalin ko muna yung exponent. Ibalik ko na lang siya mamaya sa final answer. So we have 40. And the PXY is also 40. Then for the second point coordinate, the IY is 100. And negative 40 is the negative PXY. Okay? So, we're now ready to plot the points. Okay, so let's say here is the X. Okay. So, here is the X-axis. So, lakihan ko na. And here is the y-axis. Okay, so the x-axis corresponds to the inertia, and the y-axis corresponds to the product, moment of inertia. Okay, so let us plot the points. The first point is 40, 40. So let's say this is 40, and this is also positive 40. Okay, so the points would be somewhere here. Okay, so that is, so this means this horizontal distance here is the Ix, and this vertical distance here is the Pxy, which is also 40. Okay, so then the second point coordinate is 100 and negative 40. So, kung 40 yan, siguro ito 80, siguro nandito yung 100. Tapos negative 40. Negative 40, kung positive 40 to, yung negative 40, malamang nandito. Again, this is negative 40. Tapos ito naman. Okay. Ito yung positive 100. Again, this is the IY. Ito naman yung IX. Ito PXY, PXY. Okay? So, maybe somewhere here. So, here is the point. Here is my first point. Here is my second point. Okay? So, I'm going to connect these two points para ko ma-achieve yung diameter of the circle. So, there I have the diameter of the circle. And bisecting it, this would be most like, okay, so this would be the diameter of the Mohr circle. Then most likely, if I'm going to trace the Mohr circle, this would be the circumference of the Mohr circle. Okay, so these are the points on the Mohr circle. Okay, so next is to locate for the x and the y axis on the Mohr circle. So on the section, here is the x axis and here is the y axis. So again, yung x axis will be located on the Mohr circle kung nasaan yung Ix. So since yung Ix nandito, ito yung point ng Ix. So from the center, you connect the line, that would be the x axis. Ito yung x axis. How about the y axis? Yung y-axis, pagdating sa Mohr circle, is located kung nasaan yung Iy. Nasaan yung Iy? O, ito yung Iy, no? So, ito yung point ng Iy. So, from the center of the circle, okay, so here, punta roon. So, ito ngayon yung I, yung y-axis sa Mohr circle. So, again, mapapansin mo, yung x tsaka y-axis sa Mohr circle is 180 degrees. And that is from 90 degrees angle between them, from the section, times 2, kaya siya naging 180 degrees. And another thing, yung x and y axis dito, is hiwala na siya sa horizontal axis natin, katulad nung last example natin, yung last video natin. No? Yung last video natin, yung x and y axis sa Mohr circle, lies on the horizontal axis, kasi zero product moment of inertia nung section natin from the previous example. For this example, as given, it's not zero. May value, 40. Kaya siya wala sa horizontal axis. Now, next, okay. So, let us answer the questions now. Letter A, determine the maximum and the minimum moment of inertia. So, where can you find at the circumference of the circle the one with the maximum? So, hindi ba't ito yun? So, from that point, the maximum. Okay, so project ko lang siya rito sa baba. Okay? So hanggang dun sa y-axis here. So this would be our Imax. Okay? How about the minimum? So yung minimum naman is located here. Okay? So from there hanggang sa y-axis. So, ito naman yung minimum na hanapin natin. Okay, so solving for it. So, start with I mean muna. Okay, so what would be the equation to solve for I mean? Okay, so gawa tayo ng ano, ng triangle. So if we consider this triangle, okay, so this one, okay, so let us call this angle say alpha, okay, and let this be as x, and let this be as y. Okay, so from there, what is I mean? I mean could be, it could be taken from Ix. So let's say Ix, so that distance plus x, okay, plus x, then from here hanggang dito, diba this is radius r. Okay, so minus r. Again, Ix, horizontal distance Ix, plus x, then minus r. What is left is I mean. Okay, so we need to solve for that x and r first. Okay, so, but, what is x? What is x? Actually, yung x na to, diba ito yan? That is, pagka minus ko yung Ix, Iy. Iy minus Ix. So, ano yung distance na yan? Iy, ito, 100. Minus yung Ix. So, diba ito yun? That is dalawang x. So, pagka dinivide ko sa dalawa to, that would give me the value of x. Okay? So, that would be Iy is 100. Ix is 40 divided by 2. So, I got now 60 over 2 is 30. And what is y from this triangle? Diba yung y distance na yan, that is 40. Ito yun, 40. Yung y distance is 40. So, therefore, what is radius r? So, 3, 4, 5 triangle, no? So, x is 30, y is 40, so it will follow that r is 50. 3, 4, 5 triangle. O kaya, pwede mong makuha yan from the square root Pythagorean theorem of x square plus y square. So, 50 rin pa rin yung radius r. Okay, so therefore, so going back to I mean is equal to ix. Our ix is 40. Plus x, our x is 30. Minus r. Okay, our r is 50. So therefore, our minimum inertia is 40 plus 30, 70, minus 50 is 20. Then, ibalik lang yung exponent na 6 and the unit. So that would have the answer for the minimum inertia, mm to the fourth. Okay? So, or pwede rin naman, o pwede tayo mag-generate ng another equation for I mean. Yung una equation na ginamit natin kasi is I mean in terms of Ix. So, this time, let's try solving for I mean in terms of Iy. So, how is it? Ito yung I mean, ito yung Iy. So, paano mo ma-achieve yung I mean distance based from Iy? So, 100, agan dito. Okay, so, ito rin, x din yan, no? Similar triangle naman siya rito. Ito rin yung x. Ito rin yung 40. Ito rin yung alpha. So, that would be Iy minus x. Minus x. Iy. Bawasan mo ng x. Bawasan mo ng r. Bawasan mo pa ng r. So, that would give you the I mean. So, Iy is 100. Minus yung x natin is 30. Minus yung r natin is 50. So, therefore, the same lang yung sagot. 100 minus 30 is 70. 70 minus 50 is still 20. Ibalik yung exponent, the 6. Tapos yung unit na mm to the 4th. So, the same answer lang. So, I suggest sa exam, much better kung gagawin mo yung dalawang methods para ma-check mo na rin kung yung answer mo is correct. Okay. Next. How about 4i maximum? So, here. How about 4i maximum? Okay, so again, the I maximum is here. Okay, so yung distance na from the y-axis hanggang dun sa point na yun, yun yung I maximum. So let us solve this in terms of Ix muna. So I maximum is equal to Ix plus x plus radius r. Plus x plus radius r. Nakuha nyo? Horizontal distance Ix plus x distance plus radius r, diba radius din to, that would give you the I max. So substituting values, we have 40 plus x is 30 and r is 50. So plus x, 30, plus again r is 50. So therefore, our maximum inertia is 40, 70 plus 20, so plus 50, that's 120. Balik yung exponent to the 6, and you have the mm to the 4th. So that is now our I max. Okay, likewise, pwede rin natin ma-solve yung I max in different equation involving in terms of I y. So how is the equation? What's I max in terms of I y? I max is equal to I y. Paano makakuha tong distance to with respect to I y? Pwedeng I y, bawasan ko muna ng x. Kasi ibalik ko yung r. Bawas x, dagdag radius r. That will give you Imax also. Again, Iy, bawasan ko ng x, tapos idagdag ko yung radius r. So that would give you the Imax also. Iy is 100, minus x is 30, plus r is 50. And that would give you the same answer. So 70 plus 50, that's 120 also. Again, exponent 6. At saka yung unit niya na mm to the 4th. So, that would be the same answer. Okay? Now, last. How about for the... This is point... question A. This is also question A din pala, no? Okay. So, how about for letter B? So, letter A din pala yung IMAX. So, let's have question letter B. What's question letter B? Determine the angle that the axis of maximum inertia makes with the x-axis. So let us solve that angle as theta. Call it as theta. Yung angle na tinatanong, what's theta? Okay. If this would be the section and this is the x-axis, we need to identify muna nasaan yung maximum moment of inertia. Okay, maximum moment of inertia. Yung axis of maximum moment of inertia. Okay, so if I'm going to assume na kunwari andito siya. Again, ito yung axis of Imax. If I assume that this is the axis of maximum inertia, yung angle that the axis of maximum inertia makes with the x-axis would be this one. So, yun tinatanong yung theta. Again, yung theta is the angle between the axis of maximum inertia makes with the x-axis. Okay. So, paano isosolve yung theta yan? So, itong theta na to is an angle measured from the section. So, kailangan natin i-transfer yan papunta dun sa Mohr circle. Okay. So, nasaan yung kung theta 2 dito, pagdating sa Mohr circle, magiging times 2. Magiging twice theta or 2 theta. Now, kung ito yung x-axis dito, ito yung x-axis sa Mohr circle, nasaan yung axis of maximum inertia pagdating sa Mohr circle? Okay. So, as you can see from this figure, okay, so, ito yung x-axis. Nasaan yung axis of maximum inertia pala dito? Hindi ba ito yun? Ito yung Imax eh. Ito yung Imax eh. So, ito yung point of maximum inertia. Therefore, ito yung axis of maximum. Ito yung axis of Imax sa Mohr circle. Ito yung x-axis sa Mohr circle. Ulit, ito yung Imax natin. So, ito ngayon yung axis of Imax. Andito. Tapos, ito yung x-axis sa Mohr circle. So, di bali, ang hinahanap natin is ito. Yung angle between them. The angle between the axis of maximum inertia and the x-axis. Anong tawag dito sa angle na to? Kung theta yung tawag natin dito, pagdating sa Mohr circle, this is twice theta na. Diba? So, twice theta. Pero ang hinahanap natin yung theta kasi that is the original angle dun sa section. So, solving for that theta, so paano? So, as you can see, so how do you solve for theta? So, based from the Mohr circle, 2 theta plus alpha. So, from Mohr circle, we could say that 2 theta plus alpha is equal to 180. Tama? No? So, yung twice theta plus alpha is equal to supplementary. So, 180 degrees. Okay, so we have 2 theta. What is alpha? Alpha is the angle on this triangle of x and y. So, that would be arctangent. Pwedeng arctangent of y over x. Okay, so arctangent of y. Y is 40 and x is 30. Equals 180 degrees. Okay, so from here, I could now solve for my theta, yung tinatanong. And that is equal to arctangent of 40 over 3. So, 180 minus that angle. Tapos divide ko ng 2. So, the answer is 63.43449 for 882 degrees. Okay? So, yan ngayon yung answer. Yan ngayon yung angle that the axis of maximum moment of inertia makes with the x-axis. Okay? So, I hope you have learned from this lecture video regarding section properties.